Good morning, everyone. And I've been kind of working on my curtain greenhouse. I'm going to kind of show you what I'm doing. I did a layer of the shower curtains over this way, and then I'm doing one across the top. Okay, so what we're going to do is, the plan is to go all the way up that wire. Okay, and all the way up that wire, I will be putting these panels. Now, the reason I didn't just get a roll of plastic, number one, is because I got all of these shower curtains and table protectors for almost free with clearance shopping and penny shopping. Same with the clips. And right now, what I'm using are these basic, really plastic kind of clothespins. But what you want to do is, you want to make sure that when you do your pins, you get them all the way to that bottom, that top one, and it clicks. You want it to be secure. So you want these to be very secure when you put them on and as you layer them. Now, let me open this little wire gate here. Okay, and we're gonna go inside. I'm gonna kind of show you what I'm gonna do here. So, as you can see, it doesn't drape all the way down to the ground. There's about 2 foot, maybe a foot and a half to the ground. And what I'll do is take another one and put it right along the top. So that way, we're very, very covered. Now, something else is this corner here. I will come all the way around, and I want to try to secure this whole corner where this, you see all this straw in one of my planter boxes. Now, all of this straw is going to go underneath here. It's going to go underneath here, and I will set my flats of seedlings in here. And that straw is not only going to be a little bit of a lift, but it's also going to keep the temperature very, very warm in here once the sun starts hitting it. So it's not going to take long to start doing this. Living in Indiana, I really have to watch my temperatures. And, you know, we had a 4-inch snowstorm like the mid-April last year. And, you know, I didn't want to have this put up if there was going to be a 4-inch snowstorm. So it's partially done. And I'm going to make sure that it's secure enough today, and we're supposed to get some rain and some wind, and we'll see if it's secure enough. Something else I did was, I turned up this one patch across right up through the sidewalk on this side, and I'm going to be amending this soil because this is where I'm going to put a lot of the vegetables that I'm going to start this year, because this is super, super nutrient. It's so dark. Now, this pile right here is kind of like a compost and rabbit poo straw pile. And what I'm going to do with that is, I'm going to roll down one of these tires and I'm going to fill it with that, and I'm going to grow my potatoes in that. So we're going to test drive some straw planting. This year we are going to start putting out straw areas, and we're going to do the Ruth Stout method. I don't know if I said her name correctly or not, but she has the most phenomenal straw planting idea that I've ever seen in my entire life. So that's what we're going to do. But I just wanted to show you, you know, the beginnings of my shower curtain greenhouse. And this is going to be awesome because it's going to hold in the moisture, the straw is going to hold in the heat, and hopefully, you know, my seeds will start sprouting. Now, I have some things going on over there, my pumpkins and some tomatoes and peppers, but I don't see anything yet, but pretty soon they can go right in here and everybody's going to be happy and healthy and growing. So there you go, shower curtain greenhouse, the start. Y'all have a great day. Bye.